In this tutorial, I'm gonna walk you through creating a logo in Adobe Express, the quick and easy Create Anything app by using pre-made logo templates. As a small business owner, you often require a variety of design and marketing materials, but you might not have the budget for a designer or the real know-how to start them from scratch. Today, I'm gonna show you how Adobe Express can simplify the design process and really help easily create a professional logo. So I'm gonna make an example logo using templates for a fictional brand called Lumen Gear. What I'm gonna do is come over to plus on the top left corner. I'm gonna go logo. So we can actually start doing things from scratch by adding text and elements. How do you start from scratch if you don't really know how to design something? And that's where templates come in. So we can click on templates here at the left, and you can see there's like a bunch of results. There's actually almost 5,000 results here. Since I wanna do like more of an outdoor thing, I'm gonna type outdoor logo and then see what kind of comes up. So I'm gonna go with this one here. So when I click on the template, it just adds it to our board here. So if I click on the logo, you can see there's like a big box around this. All of these elements are there and ready to be edited, but they are all grouped. So if I click on the graphic, it says ungroup. We could just click that, and now each of these pieces can be edited individually. If I come up here on the right and I can mouse over this layers icon, I can click that and actually see all of the layers of this logo. So in order to edit this text, we just click on the text. I'm going to change adventure to Lumen. And over on the left, we have tons of different options of recommended typefaces. We can change the boldness. We can make the text flow. Click on fill. We can change the color, but we're going to talk about color after. So we'll just keep it black for now. Outline thickness. You can see it adds kind of like a stroke on the outside of the text. Opacity. Drop that down. It becomes more transparent. We can add a shape behind our text. So if we want to put a box behind it, we can do that here. If we want to add a circle behind it, we can do that here. And then animation, we can also animate that text. Right now we're talking about a logo, so it's just going to be static. We go back to our main panel here. So on the left, we have all of these options. We can change fonts by just clicking these different ones that they recommended. You can try those on for size. We can also go on a drop down here and see all the different fonts that they offer here. There's tons of different ways you can just completely change the look of these logo templates to make it yours. We're gonna change the tagline here to gear. And we can see when I type that in, now it's off center. So we can come up here to align. And if we click center, it's going to center that text on the artboard with the rest of the graphics. Something we wanna keep in mind while we are creating a logo is type hierarchy. This is how we organize text to show what is the most important and maybe what is least important. So by changing things like size, boldness, type, and color, we can make sure that people can easily see what to read first. So our tagline is going to be illuminate your path, but that is just way too aggressive. It takes over the logo. So we're going to actually select all that. So we can do that by double clicking your mouse to highlight it, or if we just click in the box, we can come over to the left and we can kind of change the size. If we want to select the text box, we can drag that and make it smaller. And I click outside of the box and then click back on the graphic. We can move it. And if we hold shift on our keyboard, a little grid comes up that just keeps it centered. I'm gonna adjust the scale of everything here until I'm happy with it. But when I try to select the word gear, it's not selecting, it's just selecting the text Lumen. And that's because the word gear is behind Lumen. You can see over here in our layers that the word Lumen is on top of gear. Two ways we can change that. We can come over here to our layers. We can click the layer on top and we can drag it below. And now gear is on top and I can select it. Or we can select our text and go command bracket on our keyboard to send that to back. Now we can see we can select the gear text because it is now above the word Lumen. So I'm just gonna give that a little bit of space to breathe and actually might make that a little bit larger. So we're just gonna move it over until it's centered. And then if you're not sure if it's centered again, you can select everything, come up to align and hit center, and then that centers everything. The red and black, don't love it. So we can come up here to theme and we have all sorts of different colors that we can pick from. Be mindful of color combinations though. You wanna ensure that like the combos that you're choosing are easy on the eyes. Oh, my eyeballs. You have to be really careful about what colors we're putting together. There are also add-ons in Adobe Express to help you check the contrast of your logo, ensuring that it is readable on various backgrounds and meets accessibility guidelines. Ooh, hello. To adjust your logo color, simply click the element, come over to fill on the left, and select your chosen color. So what we can do is come up here to our pages. And so if I click on pages, it shows like this one variation. So I can come up here to the three dots, go duplicate page. And so that makes a duplicate of my logo. We're gonna click on that duplicated page and create a copy of our logo on a light background. Then a black and white variation by changing the colors as I showed earlier. Now we have our logo on dark, we have our logo on light, we have a black version, a white version. But what we don't have is a color logo with a transparent background. So duplicate this logo. We're gonna double click on it. We're gonna come up here to background color and we're gonna hit no fill. So that is gonna have no background color. Come up to download. We're gonna pick transparent PNG and we're going to download that file. This will be important when designing things like merchandise or using your logo as a video watermark. You're gonna wanna maintain that transparency. We can add this to our brand. This is a really great place to keep all the things that you're designing for reference. So your color schemes, fonts, your logo, all the logo variations so that you have it easy to reference. So that's it. I hope you found this walkthrough helpful. Be sure to check out Adobe Express's channel for more tips and tutorials to help you build your brand.